Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, we worked on this? Wait, I don't know. We worked on something, and I showed you a bunch of this stuff. Now, in this episode, I want to work on this system a little bit more. Now, I don't remember if I showed you this, but I put a pulverizer down here, and I put a chest, and I've been making dirt with the pulverizer. And I've actually been manually filling this with the excess that I've got here. And what's happening is now the sugarcane is going into a chest, and that's being auto-crafted into plantballs, and that's being fed directly into the pulverizer. The reason I'm using a chest instead of a barrel is barrels are bugged, and if there's not 8 in the barrel, it still consumes like 7, for example, and it doesn't end up making a plantball. So everything was just being voided out, basically. So now I've got this set up, and I know that a gold chest is overkill for that spot, but it is what it is. And yeah, so I got that, and I also have a ton of plant balls that I need to actually get full of blank, full of blank. These are plant balls, full of blank. Anyway, so I've got a bunch of stuff that I need to get done with these. So one of the things I'm going to probably do is end up making an extra one of these pulverizers to take care of the excess plant balls that I've got, because it's kind of ridiculous. Now, the other thing that I need to get done is I need to get these moisteners automated. Now, I looked into it a little bit. Nobody really had any suggestions as to what to do with them, so I looked into it on my own, and I found a pretty good setup, I think, but it requires a bunch of gates. So what I'm gonna have to do is head to spawn and actually make those gates. So I'm actually not gonna go into detail on it because they're just really boring, the gates. And now I do have a couple gates, but I'm gonna have to make quite a few more in order to get this system functioning. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that off camera, and I'll be back once I've got what I need. Okay, so before I go and make the gates, I actually want to point something out. So right now, you can see I've got way too much nether wart. So I've got 1,024 stacks here, and then I've also got, this is getting kind of full. So I turned off the nether wart farm. So eventually, I'm going to be recycling anything that goes through this and then doesn't stay there. Like any excess items, like I'm eventually going to run out of space for wood, right? So eventually, I'm going to make it to where any of the items here that if they're full, they're just going to get recycled. So, just thought I'd mention that. I'm also going to replace these peat-fired engines. Every time I turn these machines on, I forget to refill the engines, and it ends up screwing up the numbers and stuff. So, and, ooh, man, we're running low on bog earth, but that's all right. So, yeah, so I just thought I'd mention that. What else? I think that's about it. So I'm going to go ahead and finish getting these gates built, and I'll be right back. Alright, so we're back, and I just gotta grab some wood. So I got the gates crafted here. I might need more, but I didn't want to make too many. I actually ended up making too many chipsets, but that's okay. It's not a big deal. But what we need to do is we need to make a couple wooden pipes. And actually, I might have some in here, huh? Ooh, 26. That might be enough. I'm also gonna need some diamond ones. No. I went diamond mining again, but I got really bored of it, so let's go ahead and make some of these guys. Where's my crafting table? And I probably don't need this many, but I will need some later. So, got some diamond gates, we got some wooden transport pipes. We're also gonna need some stone transport pipes. Dang it. Hang on. Let's see if there's any in here. Oh man, and I don't have any stone, I don't think. Let's see. Nope, I definitely do not have any stone. So I'm gonna have to get some stone crafted up. So let me do that and I'll be right back. All right, so I think I've got everything I need. So we're gonna head down here, and I think I'm gonna put the moisteners somewhere else because this is kind of not a good spot. Let me see. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention, I enchanted basically everything to as high as I could get it, and it's kind of ridiculous. I've even got protection 4 on my jetpack, so I would like to get everything maxed, but unfortunately I couldn't. What was it that I couldn't get maxed? These seem pretty maxed out. Anyway, I also did my weapons and stuff like that, so I've got some pretty awesome stuff, so. Whoa! That's crazy. Oh my goodness. Anyway, yeah, so I just thought I'd mention that because I may or may not get questions about it. Oh, geez, wait, oh, we overshot it. Fall back. All right, let's, yeah, that's what I want. Perfect. So anyway, I'm going to hollow this out and I'll be right back. Alright, so I've got this room hollowed out, and it might not be enough room for all three of these, so I'm actually only going to try to hook up this one for now. So I've actually got it elevated, I think, by at least one block, so let me just put one on top, I think that'll work. Okay, so these things are kind of complicated, because they've got so many places for items to go. So first off, I need water in there. Now, water can be input on any side, so I'm not too worried about that. I'll end up hooking that up last. Now, wheat and seeds get inserted, or wheat gets inserted into the side and seeds get inserted from the top, and then mulch gets pulled out the side and then mycelium gets pulled out the bottom. So it's kind of, yeah, it's kind of frustrating. So what I'm actually going to do, let me grab, I think I've got some extra gold chests in here. Yeah, there we go. So let's grab some gold chests, and I know I don't really need them, but you know, it is what it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go two blocks away, and I threw all the dirt into here. Let me just grab a stack of dirt out of here. So we're going to go 1, 2, and then we're going to put the chest here. And so this will be the chest for the wheat, I think. So we'll do that. And then we're also going to put another chest. 1, 2. Okay, so we're going to put another chest like here. And this will be the chest for, oops, why did I just do that? This will be, oh wait, it's going to go up. Okay, so I got to go 1. Oh, that should work. So I'll put a chest on top of there, and that should be good for that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put these two wooden pipes here, and we're also gonna put two extracting gates. Is what I'm gonna call them. So basically, what these do is you can give them little parameters. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say, maybe I have to put the pipe wire on. So I made some red pipe wire. So let me see if I can. Oh yeah, red pipe signal on. I'm going to say energy pulser. Okay. And then on the other side of this, I'm going to have stone transport pipes. And I'm going to, oops, get. Okay. So I'm going to have stone transport pipes. They're also going to have red pipe wire on them. Okay, just like this. And then I'm going to have, oops, let's put one there. And then I'm going to have some iron and gates on these here. Oh, there we go. Okay, so if I open these up, I'm going to say if there are, let's see. Okay, so if there is less than 25% fuel. So in the side is where I'm inserting the wheat. The wheat is the fuel, and I'm going to say red pipe signal. So that's going to start pulling wheat out of this chest. So we don't have any wheat in there for right now, so we're just going to leave it as it is. And then this one we're going to do, oh crap, that's the wrong one. Okay, so this one's going to be resources, and then this one's going to be fuel. So let me, fuel less than 25%, red pipe signal. And this one's going to be resources less than 25%, red pipe signal. So that's how that works. Now we're going to do one more on the bottom here for the mycelium. And we're going to throw a stone pipe here. So this one's extracting from the machine itself. And so we're going to put one of these here. And we're going to, actually, you know what? Give me that back. I think I can use a regular gate. A tart, whatever those gates are. So throw this guy on. And we're going to say items in inventory. Energy pulser. So that will pull out mycelium if there's mycelium in the inventory. And then we're going to do the same thing here. We're going to say items in inventory. Oops. Items in inventory. Energy pulser. And we're going to throw one of these guys there. And we're going to throw another gold chest here. I guess we can do this on the ground like that. So let me, I think I'm going to break this one and do the same thing, because I like that better. Okay, so I hope this works. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab some wheat and some seeds out of here, and we've actually got, we're going to do 3 stacks of wheat and I guess we'll do 3 of each. That'll be simple. So we're going to throw the wheat in here, and the wheat should start getting extracted and put in there, and then we're going to put the seeds up here, and the same thing should happen with the seeds. Now what's going to end up happening is nothing is going to happen because there's no water in here. Okay, so the wheat went into the right spot, and this isn't on, which is good because we don't want it to be pulling items out until it's finished. Okay, and then let's see. Seeds should be going in now. Any moment, seeds. Oh, I broke this. Red pipe signal, energy pulser. Okay, so that should pull seeds. So those should go in the top. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab... I've got... Well, let's head up here. I think I have one of these things anyway. An aqueous accumulator. There we go. We're also going to grab... We need some of these pipes over here. Liquid ducts, rather. So grab some of those. And I think I've got... Oh, is that buckets? Oh, yeah. I'm all prepared. Not really. Let's go grab some water real quick. And then we'll head down there. So, we just need two buckets, really. I'm gonna grab three anyway. I don't care. Let's go. I'm gonna head down here. Okay, so I'm gonna... do I have any... Oh, yeah, I do. Perfect. I'm gonna put, like, a little dam here or something. I don't know. Prevent the water from flowing backwards. So we're gonna put our aqueous accumulator... Aqueous accumulator, just like that. So the front is actually facing away. And we're going to put our water here and here. I suppose I could make this. Nope. No, I can't. They're not going to be source. That's okay. So all we're going to do is take this and make it flow into here. And then I got to grab my what's this thing called? Crescent hammer. Oh, yep. So I'm gonna grab this guy and smack that guy. Okay, and that should fill this with water. And it's starting to work now, but it's actually pretty light in here, so I'm actually gonna make it a little bit darker. And eventually I'll mob proof this room by putting slabs on the floor or something like that. But for now I just want to make it dark enough that this thing will start working at basically full speed. So now it's gonna be pretty dark. And it appears to be working. So I'm gonna have to do something similar every time I hook this up. Now, I'm thinking I might be able to make... No, I have to have these two separate. I built this in single player, and it worked out pretty well. There's probably a better way to do it, so if you guys know about that... Oh, check that out. What is that? Is that already a piece? Oh, that's awesome. Okay, cool. So, I've already got a piece of mulch out of this, so that's pretty cool. So yeah, I'm pretty excited. Let's see, this says fuel less than 25%. So once this thing fills up a little bit, we should see it turn off. And actually, you know what we can do is we can take this down. We can say less than 10%. And we'll do the same thing up here. Our resources less than 10%. So that way it's not constantly pulling and there's enough room in here for things to work out. So I think that's pretty good. So I'm gonna let this run for a little bit and I will check back with you guys once I see some progress on it. Alright, I am back, and as you can see, we've got two pieces of mycelium already. For some reason, we've also got mycelium in this chest. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and turn this thing off. And see if I get all my mycelium out into this other chest. So I'm just going to put this in here, and hopefully that means all I need to do is just let this thing run and have one output instead of two. That'd be really cool. The next thing that I have to do to make this actually completely automated is give it a system like we've gotten here that'll refill it with what it needs. So in order to do that, I'm gonna need three managers or four. I think I'm gonna need to put four managers in here, one for each of these chests and then one for an ender chest that'll be attached to that system. So I think I'm gonna go ahead and hook that up. Try to figure that out. I haven't tried that yet, so I'm gonna go ahead and see. I think I actually have exactly four managers, so let's actually head up here together and see. Because if I do have exactly four, then that would be super cool. I might be one short, though. Ah, see? One short. Let me check in here, just because I have a feeling. Nope, no extra managers. So I gotta go make one more manager, and I will be back once I've got that finished. Alright, so I've returned, and I haven't made a manager yet, because I got thinking, it's dangerous for me to think, and so I know I shouldn't have done that. But I started thinking about this, and I kind of realized that there's a much better way than managers. As far as the resources required, it will take a few extra, but it's just simpler. Managers are kind of annoying to deal with. You gotta run power to them and all that. So what we're gonna use instead is filters. Now, I know I have a bunch of filters upstairs, so let me go grab them, and we'll hook this up to filters instead. So let me throw these managers back in, and I've got 9 filters. I don't need that many, but I'm gonna grab them all anyway. The other thing that I need is I need some timers. So I think I'm actually gonna craft, some timers. That might be enough. I might have enough timers. I'm not going to craft any. So, we've got these red alloy wires. We've got some timers. I think I need redstone torches, which aren't too expensive. So I'm going to go ahead and make some of these real quick. Let's grab 20. Let's make 12 of these guys. We're running short on redstone here. So go ahead and do this. Oops. Give me that. Thank you. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and head down here, and we're gonna hook this all up together. I think it'd be cool for you guys to see. Ooh, man, this room is gonna be scary. I'm also gonna probably rearrange this a tiny bit because I can push it all into the wall a little bit. Let's see how much. Oh, we've got 8 mycelium, so that means the mycelium's coming out this side. Although the mulch is not. We may need to wait for the mulch to hit the top here. I think that's what's going to happen. So let me take the wheat out of here, just so it doesn't refill itself. And I guess we can just throw it in here. Not a big deal. Because otherwise this thing's going to be trying to pulse more wheat in there. And that's not what we want. Actually, let's take this wheat out. And when this filters around, it should be okay. So let's see. I'm going to actually just watch this and I'll be right back. All right, so it's almost done. The mycelium just popped down here, so it should get sucked out any minute now. Not too concerned with that, though. Although it doesn't seem to be detecting it, does it? Might need to do something a little more advanced than what I've got here. The mycelium would eventually get pulled out, but... Oops. Don't do that to me. Yeah, so once this last cycle goes through, this should pop up in the top here. And then everything should get pulled out by that pipe there. So let's see. So this is the last one. So this will run through, and then this should turn on. So let's see if that's what happens. See if we can get them both in the shot. There we go. So we can see that, and nothing. Oh, that got pulled out. Does this get pulled out? Oh yeah, it's pulling these out too. Perfect. So that's exactly what we want. Now the one thing that I was saying is I might change is I'm gonna go ahead and grab this iron AND gate, and this is just a regular gate. What? Oh, what kind of gate are you? You're just a regular, silly gate. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna replace this bottom gate here. Oops, excuse me. Thank you. And I'm also gonna replace this gate. So let me show you the way that I'm gonna hook this up. I'm gonna take a wooden pipe. Whoops, give me that. Take a wooden pipe here. Oops. Ah, dang it. And I'm gonna take an iron, what are these? Iron extraction gate is what I've been calling them. Where is it? Oh, there we go. So we're gonna take one of these guys and we're gonna put it here. Okay, so we're gonna say, you know what? No, you know what? It's better the way it was. So I'm just gonna rip out this chest since it's not needed anymore. Oh. Shoot, my pickaxe is too fast for this place. Okay, so yeah, I'm just gonna leave it as it was instead. So I'm place that there. Sorry if it's really dark. yeah, there's not much I can do about that. It is kind of cool how these chests glow. It's really, really interesting. What was I doing? I need just a regular gate here. So I'm gonna just say energy pulser if items in inventory. So, and that'll take them all out. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the filter system set up, and I'll be back when I'm finished. All right, so I've moved this down onto the floor, And I think that's a good place for it. I hope that'll work. So the only thing I haven't hooked up is I gotta get this red pipe signal. I actually have to configure the gates too. I'm actually gonna do that off camera though. So I've got this hooked up now. What I wanna do is I don't have any of these tubes. Let me see if I've got any tubes in here. I do, fantastic. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hook up, let me in, one of these tubes to either side of these. And I'm also going to hook up one filter like this. Oops, give me that. Okay, and I think that's facing the wrong way. That's fine. And then one more like that. And that's also facing the wrong way. But that's cool. It's all good. So we're just gonna, give me that. Where'd that screwdriver go? Did it go back in the bag? You silly. All right, so I just gotta make sure, that this faces that way. And I hate when they're always on the last one. There we go. So these are both facing the right direction now. So what I have to do is I also have to hook up two timers. Goodness, I cannot speak. So one of them is gonna go there and another one is gonna go up top, but it's gonna be kind of hard to hook that up. So what this is gonna do is I'm gonna hook up, what am I doing here? I need cobblestone structure pipes. Let's head upstairs. Oh my goodness. Heading up and down the whole time. The whole episode is me up and down. Actually, let me, seems my frame rate's going a little silly. So I'm gonna set my view distance down to normal. Hopefully that'll help a little bit. It seems choppy. So what am I doing? Oh, now I forgot. Oh yeah, cobblestone structure pipe. So what I'm gonna use this for is to attach to here. I'm always afraid there's gonna be mobs in here. Okay, so attach this to here, okay? And another one, I'll probably do it on this side. Because I could do it on this side, but it might cover up the chest. So I'm gonna do it there, and then we're gonna put a piece of dirt right here. And then we're going to take our timer. Should only need two, I think. Okay, we got another timer there. And we're actually going to take another piece of dirt here. And that should actually be enough. So what we're going to do is we're going to take red alloy wire. And we'll eventually attach it to that timer. And we're going to do the same thing here. And again, we'll eventually attach it to the timer. But we don't want this going yet. So the next thing we need to do is we need to just take... You know what? I think I have some regular gates. Oh well, I'm just going to use these and gates. That's fine. So I'm going to throw one on each of these pipes here. And then I'm going to configure them like this. So I'm going to say, if the inventory is empty, then give a redstone signal. There's a better way to do this. Okay, I gotta move this. So what we're gonna do is, instead of doing it the way that I just showed you, is I'm gonna put a piece of dirt here, and then I'm gonna put a redstone torch on the dirt. And I don't think redstone torches give off enough light to cause any issues. I hope that's true. It might, because if these aren't light level zero, I don't like it. Okay, I got a better idea. I guess we can punch out the torches and see. And then close off this. So let's see. Oh, yeah, that gives off way too much light. What? Where's this light coming from? What the heck? What? Minecraft, you're drunk. Okay. Okay, so it's super dark in here. These things give off way too much light. Look. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh man. Okay. Well, that's all right. We'll figure something out. What we could probably do. No, that wouldn't work. Shoot. Okay. I guess we're gonna put the timers like way over here, or something. Let me figure this out, and I'll be right back. All right. So I think I've got this figured out, and I'm pretty sure that this is as close as possible without causing light. Now, I put them on the roof because it's really not, it doesn't make the room any bigger, so I can actually end up putting a wall around this whole thing, and that's what I'm going to do. There's going to be a wall that starts here, and it's going to go kind of like this, or exactly like that, maybe one block in, actually. That way I can use this, the rest of the space here, for something else. No, I think I'm going to make it one block bigger, because I want this to be accessible, but I don't want to have to put light in here. So you can see that the redstone torches here emit light, but it actually only emits light just before it hits the moistener here. So everything, as far as that's concerned, should be good to go. So I'm going to actually just finish lining this. So I think I'll do it something like that, and I'll do something with the door to prevent light from getting in there. I might do a piston door or something like that. But yeah, so you can see basically what happens is the AND gate here, which I'm going to change for a regular gate eventually, goes up and hits a redstone torch, which inverts the signal. Basically what the condition is going to be is if there are no items in the inventory, give a redstone signal. And that's going to run the timer, and then there's going to become items in the inventory, and that's going to turn off. And actually I'm going to... Oh, jeez. Let me rejoin the server. I'll be right back. All right, I am back. And go away, help. So don't right-click that with a block that's placeable. Turns out that crashes your client. Okay, so I'm actually going to change these down to 0.2 seconds. Yay. They're going to spew. Actually, no, that's way too much. No. Yeah, no, it is. I'm actually going to set it to 5 seconds. The reason being is these... Even if I pulsed it that fast, these things wouldn't refill that fast, the chest here. So, let me pull out the stack of dirt that went in there and throw that back through the system. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the stack of wheat and the stack of seeds. So I'm going to throw wheat in this filter, because this is the one that goes in the side. I'm going to throw seeds in this filter. Okay, so it says inventory empty, redstone signal, and it put dirt back in there, dang it. Okay, so this time we should get wheat. Bam, and that turns off. Sweet. It's basically just pulling one stack at a time, which is all that we really need. Same thing goes for this one. So once I configure this gate here, which I'm going to do right now, inventory empty, redstone signal. I guess it's already configured. What's in there? Oh, seeds. There's already seeds in there. So if I were to pull the seeds out, you would see that this thing... Oops, I don't have enough inventory space to do that. As soon as the inventory becomes completely empty, this thing turns on. It should go one time and then turn right back off, which it did, which is fantastic. And actually, I guess I could set it to 2 seconds because it actually did refill that quickly. So I'm going to set them both to 2. Why not? So that's basically this system ready to go. The only thing I need to do is set up these gates. So I'm going to do that really quickly. All right, so I've got those configured. So this thing should start filling up the moistener here. And we'll see if seeds pop in here. If it starts going, it should go. And that would mean that this system is now completely automated. So the very last thing that I'm going to end up hooking up onto this is a way to turn it off if we're full on either mulch or the other stuff. So let me open this. And I think the light level actually does bleed into here. Oh, that might be just perfect. I am going to end up lighting this area up and filling in walls and stuff. But for now, let's see. This thing is going fantastic. So yeah, like I said, if we end up filling up on either mulch or mycelium, where is my mycelium? I made a bunch of mycelium and we ran out of mulch. That's because what are the mushroom farms? They are completely dead, basically. So I have to rehook those up. What am I trying to say here? Anyway, that's the end of the episode, so I want to thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, go ahead and leave a rating, and until next time, I will see you guys later.